With an eye on next month's local elections, Labour are determined to make the new community charge a vote loser for the government. It doesn't come into effect for another year, and the exact figures aren't yet known. But what is clear is that the impact of the community charge or poll tax will vary substantially. If the new system was in operation now, Harlow's 55,000 adults would each be paying £384 this year. But in Epping Forest, the bill would only be £238. Each one of Epping Forest's 88,000 adults would be a massive £146 a year better off than their new town neighbours. In London, Camden could be imposing the highest community charge in the country, £568 per adult per year. Yet Redbridge would have the lowest charge in the country, a mere £160 per adult per year. A poll tax protest, Mr. Kinnock, but you've protested before. It's not done you much good.
This will do good because this is the only means that the British people will have of recording their strong majority hostility to the poll tax. And in a democracy, if simply because an Act of Parliament was passed, the opposition and everybody else just lay down and allowed the government to roll over them, we will have seen the end of democracy.
The government will not be swayed. They say the community charge is fair and long overdue. They plan special measures to ease the changeover, and rebates will still be available for people on low incomes. But the new tax is also going to be expensive to collect.
Here at Southwark, they're already sending out registration forms for the new tax, which doesn't come into operation until next year. But already they're complaining about the cost of this changeover.
42,000 rate demands are being replaced by 180,000 poll tax forms. New computers are having to be bought to cope with the work, and this new building's going up in record time to house them. Southwark say just gearing up for the new tax is costing them £5 million. Barbara Long, Thames News.